हेलो गाइस, माय नेम इज़ शर्मिन एंड टुडे इन दिस वीडियो वील बी लुकिंग एट जावास्क्रिप्ट फंक्शंस. व्हाट वील बी लर्निंग इज़ वी विल बी लर्निंग व्हाट आर फंक्शंस एंड देन वील बी सीइंग हाउ टू राइट जावास्क्रिप्ट फंक्शंस एंड देन वील ऑल्सो सी हाउ दे वर्क एंड एट द एंड वी विल सी वाई वी यूज फंक्शंस इन जावास्क्रिप्ट. Okay, so first of all, we'll see what are functions. Okay, so functions are a block of code, okay, that perform a task only when called. Okay, so let's do it practically and see, it will be more clear. So first of all, let's see how to write a function. Okay, so to write a function, we use the keyword function and then the name of the function here. Let's give it a name of greet, for example, and then these round brackets and then curly braces. Okay, and inside of the curly braces, let's log a statement saying hello. So this is how we write a normal function. We use the keyword function and then here is the name of the function. Sorry, this greet is the name of the function and then these parentheses and then we have the curly braces and then this is the block of code, okay, that will be executed when this function will be called. Okay, when this function will be called, this will be the block of code that will be executed. All right, so now this is how we write a function in JavaScript. Now if we want to call this function, how can we call it? So we call a JavaScript function by writing its name. For example, here it is greet and then using these parentheses, the round brackets, alright, and then when we save it, and can you see in the console, hello is being printed. So this is how we write a function, and then this is how we call the function, alright. So this is a very basic function in JavaScript. This is not the only way that we can write functions. There are many other ways we can write functions in. Okay, so let's see functions with parameters now. Okay, so here we have function and then let's give it a name of greet guest and then let's pass a parameter over here. Okay, inside the parentheses we'll pass the parameter. Okay, and then inside the curly braces we'll be logging the statement saying hello, yes, and then we'll be using the name parameter inside over here. Okay, so now what we did in the function above this was we just called the function right here. What we'll be doing, we'll be calling the function greet guest and then we'll be passing an argument over here. Okay, so what this will be doing is, this is the parameter, right, the name. So when we call this function greet guest, it will be waiting for a value, right, for this name parameter which we have given it. So what we can do here is, for example, we can pass the value as John and then can you see hello John is being printed over here. So this is how functions with one parameter work. Okay, and we have functions with multiple parameters also, so after this we'll be seeing functions with two parameters. All right, so okay, so here what is happening is we write this function right with a parameter over here called name and when we call the function we give the parameter a value of John. Right, we gave the parameter a value of John, that is, this is called the argument. Okay, whatever you give inside the parentheses here when you are making the function, that is your argument, and then whatever is the value, sorry, this is the parameter and whatever value you provide to it is the argument. All right, so this is how we write functions with one parameter. Okay, and now let's see functions with two parameters. For example, sum, and then you have the values a and b, addition equal to a plus b, and then let's return console.log and then the value of addition Okay, and now let's call this function. Now here there was no parameter, right? Here we gave one parameter, and here can you see we use this comma to separate both the parameters over here. Okay, so now to call this function, we write the name of the function, that is sum, and then here it is asking for two parameters, right? So here we'll be giving two arguments, that is 1 and 2, for example, and then when we save, can you see we get the output as 3. So what happens here is we have two parameters here, right? So when we call the sum function sum, we take the first argument and then give it to the first parameter over here, and then we take the second argument and give it to the second parameter over here, right? And then we are adding both of them, and then we are displaying the output in this variable called addition. Okay, so let's try this with 2 and 4, for example. It should give us back 6, right? So when we refresh, can you see it printed 6 in the console? So this is how functions work. These are the very basic functions. So what we saw is we saw normal function, a very basic function without any parameters, and then we saw a function with one parameter, and then we saw another function with two parameters, right? And now why we use functions? Now functions are used where, now for example, if you're writing a program and you see that a block of code is being repeated again and again, so instead of writing those 3-4 lines of code again and again, what you can do is you can create a function and then use that function. You saw we can use a function in one line, right? So instead of writing those 3-4 lines, we can make a function and then use that function again and again inside the program. So this really helps in writing clean code. So hope you guys understood, and if you have any queries regarding this or any doubts, post it in the comments below and I'll be answering them all. And thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Thank you so much.